Okay, in the hurry of Oniva here, my gosh, I found a statement on the internet about the Oars, and the Oars are, it's terrible actually, it's a terrible statement. It's about the bear skins. It says to sell the bear skins, the skin of the bear, the hide, sell the hide of the bear before killing. So it is an interesting statement, and yet it has been translated through time, through the time, and changé into don't sell your chickens until they are hatched. Do not sell the chickens until they are hatched. So it's been changed from the oars, the bears, which is incorrect. It's already been changed in the animal. From the bears to the chickens, and now it is not not even the same sentence any longer. They don't use the word even really in the killing, and that's incorrect. Why can't we use the original sentence and what it was worth? Because it is a value. It is a value. Do not sell. Do not sell. I'll try to get it exact here. It's do not sell it. Where am I here? Gosh dang it, this computer is constantly playing the games with me. It's like, you're here, you're not here. Come on, stop it. You know, it's like, it's companion that is an elusive that doesn't want to play fair. Okay, so we are here, vendre le peu de l'or avant de l'avoir tué. So, vendre la peau de l'or avant de le voir tuer. So, sell the hides of the bear before the killing. So why would anybody want this going on? Why would you want to be selling the hide of the bear before you go to a killing? Mainly, I think if you, in its translation this way, it is saying get rid of everything, get rid of all of your belongings and purchase what? War equipment is the saying, purchase military equipment before you go and kill something. And I'm thinking, no, that is incorrect. I don't believe that that's what it means at all. I don't think it is like some kind of secret helper there in a military tactic. I believe more so that it is actually about At some point in time, it is about old age, about persons who are old, and it's very possible that the tribe itself here in the discussion just kill the old. This is it. You're at a certain point in your life. You're being killed. That's it. You've reached a level. You have your max quota. You know, and it is time for you to be dead. And it is tué, it is the killing moment. And so it's perhaps maybe they didn't have a pretty word for mort or anything. And so I believe that is more what it is. It is like simply, you've gotten too old, you sell your items, and then we kill you. And it is probably something that was more for the family. More for the family to just deal with, the tribe itself, the tribe of persons will say, well, you know, you've reached your max limit of lifetime, you've overdone your bear haul with your clothing, that's it, and so now we kill you. And that's a life. So I believe that's what it's more in the meaning. I don't think it has anything to do with the chickens being hatched. And here it is saying, the proverb is, it has been translated into to count one's chickens before they're hatched. So they have absolutely changed it. And seeing as how I am the bear legend of the blason typique, extraordinaire, my goodness, bring the bear back, because the bear is an important item in the situation. We're talking the hide of the bear. I mean, this is how old the proverb is. So if we have a proverb that is as old as the hide of the bear, why are we putting it with chickens? Why did the bear itself get replaced with chickens? This is the atrocity I'm looking at already. Is why would it be replaced with the chickens? Yeah. So anyway, so this goes to the right of life and everything, and all of that. I guess I was having this weird conversation with, you know, obviously I have to state this because it's a government moment, but yeah, I'm not in the supporting of keeping extra money supplied out for persons that are so unwell and that they are hooked up to machines. That will be the onus of stopping it. They need to stop it. The family members need to stop those machines that are going and clicking their heart of movements. So yeah, all of that has to be going on. I believe in that right to death. Absolutely. And it does not have to be the hospital either. But yeah, by the family members themselves. Oh my goodness. But yeah. I guess that was all that I was really wanted to speak of. I had a big conversation earlier with I was discussing this opposites of language, and I didn't really want to upload all of it. It's too much of a video, it's too long. I'll just try to keep it simple. Simple things like to fix the statue, Zoltan, bring him out of the cement, bring him up, lift him up a little higher. I want to see all of his legs, all of his feet there, 2 feet, firmly planted on the ground rather than buried under concrete. So yeah, we need to raise his statue, and that is in Hungary, that's the statue. So what else has to be done? Oh my goodness. I did have also one more problem. We're like, okay, how do we support all of this? Because, well, same as Nevada style, same as Monaco, we have the casinos at the beginning, not the supermarket, but yeah, the gambling halls, the gaming centers. They are the uplift rise to create this extra money, extraordinaire, that we not need to be taking so much from business and so much from the individual on personal income taxes. So because I'm denouncing personal income taxes, in the beginning we may need a few select businesses that we are going to be garnering taxations from, and those taxations will help to build the casinos. Once the casinos are built, we can remove those taxes. So that's really the premise, is to take the taxations from the a few businesses only, and the ones that to build the casinos, I will have to push it to the major supermarkets also. That will be the major stores. So it'll be on the food supply. I'll have to use the taxation there to help build the casinos. But later on, hopefully, we'll get that removed. I don't want really taxations hanging out around when they don't have to be there. That's really the deal. Because it's not really a war beast kingdom that I have here. It's not a war beast kingdom of creating another artillerant machine. We have many other things to be creating instead. Many other things, much more important and futuristic and exciting. Much more important than war machines fighting at each other and killing. And the other thing I was saying also was there is that want already. I said the 25%. We have the 25% limit stop on a person from Britain to purchase here in France. And I'm going to update that to include others from the EU, specifically within that 25% number. The reason I'm including more persons from the EU in that number is because I remember, do not forget, the British are, you know, they are allied, they are allied with the Danes, they are allied with Spain, they are allied with others. So in their concurrent mentality, they will use those business connections to also partake of the easy purchase of France. And so I'm going to have to go with clarity there that no, you cannot have, you cannot have, you cannot have more than 25% of French lands any longer, terrains and properties. So, yeah, I'm putting a limit on it all. So there you go. I guess that was as quick as I can for this video. That's a quickie. But yeah, change this. To count one's chickens before they hatch is incorrect. It is it's about the bearskins. It's about the bearskin. It says sell your bearskins before the killing. That's really it. And the discrepancy is the killing of what? Is it the killing of the person because that's it? They're old and retired, and that's the end of their days. And that's just get rid of your items so they don't end up in storage. You know what I'm saying? And versus what? Sell everything before you go off into battle? That seems retarded. Why would you sell everything before you go off into battle? That's in a battle that's already under the assumption that you're going to die. That would be a retarded sentence. So no, it can't be this one at all. Unless it is referring to the killing of other persons. And then it would make sense. Sell your skin before the killing, you know, maybe then, the killing of others. But no, I'm thinking in the direction of language. They're really, really talking about life itself. Just get rid of everything so you don't end up, you give it away. It's your bequeathment statement right here. So your bequeathment statement of your inheritance. This is it, your bequeathal. Give it away. It's almost an order. It's almost an inheritance order. You bequeath your and sell your items away before, and you accept that you will be killed by some way or some means or some manner, and that is not a coward, is it? Not a lâcheté, not a coward.